It's being hailed as an effective treatment for cancer, autism, and other diseases. One of its leading proponents, a Pittsburgh doctor. But Action News Investigates has learned scientists question whether the treatment does any good at all.
That's right. Pittsburgh's Action News 4 investigative reporter Paul Van Osdall looked into this. Paul.
Well, the treatment is called the BX protocol. It's produced by a group called the Delta Institute. They say a key component is a derivative of crystalline fructose, a sort of natural sweetener. Now, Delta is headquartered in Hong Kong, but the BX has gained a following right here in Pittsburgh, especially among cancer patients desperate for a cure. The treatment costs $17,000. A leading oncologist at the University of Pittsburgh says, buyer beware.
Oh, I've been waiting for this.
Sorry, awesome.
Is this from my treatment center?
I think it is.
These are my new meds.
Terry Taylor of Pittsburgh documented every step of her fight with cancer, including the day the BX protocol treatments were shipped to her home.
Oh, there we go. There's my stuff.
And her trip to the Delta Institute Clinic in Salt Lake City.
On the road to health.
All the while, her father, a retired doctor and medical researcher at Pitt, was at her side. But he was not a BX backer.
My skepticism was total, and I thought it was gobbledygook.
When Terry was at the Delta Clinic, she had to be hospitalized. Still, she remained upbeat about the alternative treatment.
I have far from abandoned the BX protocol by the Delta Institute.
7 months later, Terry was dead. Her family devastated.
It was what any loving parent can imagine. I don't have words to express it.
Delta's medical director and chairman, Dwayne Smith, refused our request for an on-camera interview. In an email, Smith says Terry and other cancer patients who later died were not just taking the BX protocol, they also had gotten chemotherapy.
Cancer is
there is no evidence the BX contributed to the death of Terry or any other Delta patients. One of the biggest BX advocates is Dr. Valerie Donaldson of Aspenwall, who's on Delta's advisory council.
I've given the BX to a variety of different patients, cancer patients, patients with goiter, pulmonary fibrosis, autism, and all of them have gotten better. 100% have gotten better.
Ron Zeller was one of Donaldson's patients.
I've had, I don't know how many people tell me that it just looks so much more alive and better.
But after he did this video, he died. Laura Featheroff was another cancer patient of Donaldson's who died after doing this testimonial. Donaldson refused our request for an on-camera interview, so Action News Investigates tried to talk to her outside her office.
Do you think the BX protocol cures cancer? How can you say the cure is 100% effective when some of your own patients have died?
Donaldson told me by telephone that Featheroff and Zeller went off BX before they died. The Delta Institute refused to provide statistics on the survival rate of patients using the BX. In a statement, Delta says, "We do not use success brackets. Our model is based on performance outcomes. These outcomes are provided to the member by their referring doctor. Performance outcomes are general in nature and may vary from doctor to doctor based on the doctor's experience and relevancy to the client's condition." Smith told me by email that 98% of BX users are satisfied.
Action News Investigates received these emails from people who said the BX worked for them. However, most of these were from people who had Lyme disease. There were two cancer patients who claimed to have been cured by BX, but they declined our request for an interview. Dr.
Sally Schutz of California told me by Skype that BX cured her Lyme disease.
Well, I was dying before the BX. It saved my life. It has given me a life worth living.
And she says it works not just for Lyme disease.
I believe the BX can cure cancer.
Action News Investigates asked the deputy director of the University of Pittsburgh Cancer Institute to review the claims made by the Delta Institute about the BX protocol.
It sounds great, but unfortunately the devil's in the details. Those are great buzzwords. But as best as I could tell, there were no real publications cited.
Should that be a concern?
Yeah, absolutely. I would be concerned that, again, right, there's no peer-reviewed publications that are highlighting the work that's been done.
The Delta Institute points to this video showing a Utah State University researcher touting the BX protocol.
I just see so much potential for this because it is so different.
But Chris Davies, the director of the lab where the study was done, tells me the researcher was paid directly by the Delta Institute. He says this was not a peer-reviewed study and it was never published. Utah State University does not endorse the BX protocol, and we have no evidence that the BX protocol has any medical efficacy. Terry Taylor's father and sister want to make sure other cancer patients desperate for help do not make the same choice that Terry did.
If it was a miracle cure, we would all know about it and we would have thousands or hundreds of thousands of happy customers. This is not the case.
The Delta Institute says its success has made it a target of critics they believe are tied to the pharmaceutical industry. Now, I want to know if it's legal for Delta to use testimonials from dead clients. The Federal Trade Commission would not discuss Delta specifically, but it did say it requires anyone endorsing a product must still be using it. New at 6, we'll tell you about the background of Delta's top leaders. Paul Van Osdahl, Pittsburgh's Action News 4.